Welcome from the Nippon Budokan here in Tokyo at the 2020 Olympics for the final day of judo in the individual judo competition. Tomorrow we will have the teams. That will be the first time in judo that the team competition will be on the Olympics. So this will be a big event tomorrow. But today it's the last day of individual fights. It's two categories, the women over 78 kilograms and the men over 100 kilograms. Let's start with the women over 78.
There are few athletes competing today who can be considered true legends of judo. Idalis Ortiz is one. Her 14-year career has seen her become one of the most decorated players in judo's history and a hero to her entire nation. 6 Grand Prix, 3 Grand Slams, the World Masters, 7 World Championship medals, including 2 historic golds. Her first in Rio de Janeiro in 2013. And 1 year later, in Chelyabinsk in 2014. And medals at each of the last 3 Olympic Games, the pinnacle of which was gold in London in 2012. Ortiz is quite simply a phenomenon. But the Cuban now finds herself locked in a power struggle. It seems like a lifetime ago that Sonny Akira became the first judoka selected for the Olympic Games. The 2017 junior world champion made an immediate impact upon transitioning into seniors, taking multiple world tour victories before proving she was the real deal by claiming the senior world title at the expense of Ortiz in Tokyo in 2019. With that result, she was immediately selected for the Games and looked to be Ortiz's biggest problem. But since then, a new contender has emerged. One who at only 21 years old is already a dominant force. France's Romain Dicot is on a 27-match unbeaten run. 1 Grand Prix, 3 Grand Slams, the Europeans, and the World Masters. Seeded 5th, she would likely have to beat both Ortiz and Soné if she is to go all the way. But before then, she could meet 4th seed Maria Suelen Altman, Brazil's 2-time world silver medalist. Can she finally claim a major global title? Soné may well face the raw power of Azerbaijan's Kinzerska in her semi-final. But to get there, the Japanese woman may have to find a way past the guile of 2-time world medalist Kyra Sayet of Turkey. Belarus's Marina Slutskaya has 17 World Tour medals, but will be on the hunt for a first spot on the Olympic podium. And the Tunisian Niel Chikrahou is a 10-time African champion. So, Ortiz will already go down as one of the greatest of all time. But with 2 young challengers hungry for Olympic glory, she will have to be at her very best to bring her glittering career to a golden conclusion.
So, a few favorites in the plus 78 kilograms. Of course, Ortiz from Cuba. She already won all the colors of medals at Olympics. She won a bronze, she won a gold, and in Rio she won a silver medal. So 3 medals already, and if she will win a medal today, it will be her 4th medal at the Olympics, and that's, well, quite an achievement. Let's look at the draw. Of course, Ortiz, we don't see her so often. If she comes, she wins medals. That's why she's the highest ranked, and that's why she's on the top half. On the left side, it's Ortiz. Well, for her to get into the semi-final, I can mention, for example, Nunes from Portugal. She's a Grand Slam medalist. Sheikh Rou from Tunisia, also a very strong fighter in this category. And Xu from China, from the People's Republic of China. She's the Asian champion, won a few medals as well as at Grand Slams, things like that. So this is the top block. I think, of course, Ortiz will be the favorite here, but let's see what will happen. And on the downside, we have Altman from Brazil and Dico, of course, from France. Well, Dico did not lose a fight since, I think, Osaka 2019. She did not go to all the competitions. For example, at the World Championships in 2021, she was not there. But she won 6 golds in a row. And she's the European champion. And she won the Grand Slams the last few months. And in January at the Masters, she was also the winner. Possibly a gold medal for Dico. It is possible, I think. But on the other side, we have, of course, Sonne from Japan. Well, that's the 2019 World Championship. And in 2021, I saw her fighting once at a Grand Slam. It was in Tashkent. And there, it was an easy win for Sonne. So it's Ortiz, it's Sonne, it's Dico. And are there more fighters that maybe can win a medal here? Yeah, for sure, because on the top half on the right side we see Kinserska. And Kinserska, well, she is one of the not many fighters that actually beat Sonne. It was in 2017 at the World Championships that she also won a bronze medal. So a very strong fighter from Azerbaijan. The last one I want to mention is Tessie Savokaus from the Netherlands. She won the Masters 2 years ago. She was really, really bad injured in Paris last year. And for her, it was impossible to fight at the Olympics in 2020 because it was impossible for her to fight. They said, well, maybe you will never do judo again. They postponed the Olympics. So for a lot of athletes, it's a real pity, of course, with the COVID and everything around it. For some athletes, it gave them a new chance. And for Tessie Savokaus, this is a new chance. In 2020, it was impossible for her to fight. But now in 2021, she's there and she will be fighting again. And I think that's, before winning medals, already a real big result. Let's go to the men over 100 kilograms. And of course, well, if we're talking about the heavyweights, we can talk about one person, already 2 times gold medalist. Will he win his 3rd gold today? It's Teddy Riner from France, but there are also a few really strong opponents. Let's see.
Ten-time world and double Olympic champion Teddy Riner of France has set the standard at plus 100 kilograms. For over a decade, he has dominated the men's heavyweight division with his exceptional blend of power and athleticism. After claiming his 10th world title in 2017, he stepped away from top-level competition, and in his absence, a number of giants arose to fill the void. The Georgian warrior Guram Tushishvili was first. He had pushed Riner to the limit and fulfilled his potential by becoming world champion in 2018. The following year, the world title moved from Georgia to the Czech Republic, as the 2014 world champion and 2016 Olympic champion in the light heavyweight division, Lukas Karpalek, moved up a category and conquered the world again. Then came the return of Riner, looking to reclaim his throne. Victories in Montreal and Brasilia. He was back with a bang. But his homecoming party in Paris had a sting in the tail, not from the new champions, but from judo's homeland, Japan. Kageyura Kokoro handed Riner his first defeat in 10 years in front of a stunned French crowd. But even then, Kageyura, the Kingslayer, was himself bested. As echoes of an age-old heavyweight rivalry between Japan and the Netherlands reverberated around Bercy. Henk Grol stepping into the spotlight and into contention. Japan's strength in depth meant Kageyura lost out to teammate Harasawa Hisayoshi as the man selected by Japan to try to bring their most cherished prize home. Harasawa has come so close. With Olympic silver in Rio and world silver in Tokyo in 2019, can he now take that final giant stride to the top of the podium? You can never count out the gargantuan Brazilian, Rafael Silva. Yakiv Kamo produces some mind-blowing judo. The Ukrainian is a triple world bronze medalist, most recently last month in Budapest. Israel's Or Sasson threatens everyone with his speed and precision. But there is another, new threat, a man who sits atop the world ranking and will be seeded number one at the Games. Tamerlan Bashayev. Bashayev's incredible rise has seen him reach five Grand Slam finals in a row, taking three gold medals, and contest the world final just 1 month ago. His quick reactions and technical wizardry make him a nightmare for the bigger men in the division. But Bashayev's one major problem is the man looking to become the most successful Olympic judoka in history. Riner has made one appearance since his shock loss in Paris 2020. The World Masters in January, where he looked back to his best, defeating Bashayev on his way to the gold medal. But in Tokyo, Riner will be unseeded and could face any of his biggest rivals in the first round. Can he pass his toughest test yet and become a triple Olympic champion? The plus 100 kilograms. Big time judo.
Can Teddy Riner win his third gold medal today? Let's look at the draw, because it won't be an easy Olympics for him, for sure. If you see on his side, and that's the result of not being seeded. Teddy didn't not fight so many times in the last few years. Of course, we saw him losing against Kageura in Japan. I think he was not fit at the moment. I saw him in the Masters in 2021 and he looked in a really good shape. There he also won the gold medal, but he's not that high ranked and that's why he's non-seeded. On the top half, we see Bashayev. Bashayev won the silver medal at the World Championships in 2021. I think for a lot of people, well, it's I don't want to say a strange decision, because this man is absolutely a real brilliant fighter, but they also have Tsoyev. And Tsoyev was the European champion this year and one of the strongest athletes, in my opinion, I've seen in the heavyweight for many, many years. But the Russian Olympic Committee, they decided it's Bashayev who will be fighting, and let's see what he's capable of. He's not the tallest fighter in this section, but he uses this height, well, the lack of height, he uses this so very well, so it will be Bashayev. And then we have Or Sasson, the Rio bronze Olympic medalist, and there Teddy Riner for France. So he's been the first fight, he will be fighting Heji from Austria, strong fighter from Austria, then Sasson, then Bashayev to reach the semi-final. So that are three quite difficult fights for him. On the lower half, we see one of his biggest opponents for sure. It's Tushishvili from Georgia. Well, Tushishvili, of course, was the world champion in 2018. And this man, well, everybody thinks he will be the guy who will win so many times after Teddy's when Teddy Riner will finish. In 2018 he was the world champion. We thought he will be world champion many times, but afterwards, well, sometimes he was losing fights. You did not see him in the good shape in the competitions. If he lost a fight, it would be always that in the end he will be fifth place, because he's not fighting really hard for the bronze medal sometimes. Let's see if he's in shape here at the Olympics. Tushishvili from Georgia, but he has to be in the semi-final against Riner or Bashaev or whoever he will be facing. Then he has to fight Rafael Silva, for example. Rafael Silva already is a two-time bronze medalist at the Olympics, the big mountain from Brazil. That will be interesting to watch this block as well. Well, a few really strong fighters on the left, with, of course, Teddy Riner as the biggest opponent for everybody. On the other side, we have Harasawa. Harasawa was the silver medalist in Rio, losing the final against Teddy Riner. Harasawa, I don't know. He can be in absolutely great form. We've seen the men judoka from Japan here, and they're absolutely amazing. They already won five of the six categories. It's unbelievable. So let's see if he's in good shape. Well, then he has to face, first he has to fight Kim from Korea. Kim was already a bronze medalist at the World Championships at a really young age. He was in 1 year the junior bronze medalist and the senior bronze medalist at World Championships. That won't be easy for him. And on that side, there's also Gamo from the Ukraine. And I saw Gamo many years ago, and I thought this will be one of the strongest heavyweights for the next decade for sure. Then a few years, I did not see him fight so well. But this year in 2021, he was the guy who beat Harasawa, actually, at a Grand Slam. And at the last World Championships, he won a bronze medal. So Gamo also a really strong opponent for Harasawa to reach the semifinal. The lower half, there we have Lukas Krapalek, of course the Olympic champion of Rio, but in the minus 100 kilograms category. Krapalek already was the world champion in the heavyweight. Well, there are not many people who can do this. So he was fighting under 100, went over into the plus, and also won a big gold medal there at the World Championships. The strongest in this part for me is not because I'm a Dutch guy, but is Henk Grol. And Henk Grol, well, we saw Teddy Riner lose in Paris against Kageura. Then you think, was this the final? No, it wasn't the final, because in the final, Henk Grol was facing Kageura, and it was Henk Grol who beat Kageura to win the Grand Slam of Paris. Won a few medals, silver medal at the Europeans. This man is already three times silver medalist at the World Championships, and he also has two bronze medals at the Olympics. But most of his medals are all, of course, in the minus 100. So let's see if Krapalek and Henk Grol, two fighters that were really, really strong in the 100s, now in the heavyweight, if it's possible for them to win a medal today. So it's all about the question, will Teddy Riner win his third gold medal at the Olympics, or will there be somebody else who can win the gold today? Let's see. Have fun.